is Hope Yoder, and I want to show you how easy it is to do crazy quilting. So there's some basic principles for crazy quilting. Number one, you're going to follow the line angles of the center piece. Number two, you're never ever going to trim a tail until it turns into a seam allowance. So let's go ahead and get started. I've got my supplies here. I have several different strips of different color coordinating fabric. I have a foundation piece that you could have batting underneath or without batting. If you do, I'd recommend our Angel Loft bamboo batting. And we're going to just use a simple straight stitch. So this fabric is so pretty. This will be my foundation piece that you see here. And what we're gonna do is we're going to, scissors somewhere here, I had them. We want to take our first strip and we want to make it and cut it into a square. It doesn't have to be an exact square, and I would use a rotary cutter. And then I want to make this has four sides. I want to turn this into a five-sided piece. So the center needs to have five line angles. So you're just going to take, these were 2.5-inch strips, and I just trimmed it to a 2.5-inch square and then cut a corner off. So that's step number one. And then you want to put this down, and this is crazy quilting, crazy line angles. So I don't want this to be matchy-matchy. I want to put it cockeyed right in the center. And for this, I'm going to draw just so you can kind of see. This is going to be line angle number one. And this is going, this little bitty part here is going to be line angle number two. This is going to be line angle three, line angle four, and line angle five. So what I want to talk to you about are line angles. Remember the movie, what was the name of the movie? Now I can't think about it that I'm on camera, but To Infinity and Beyond.
Toy Story,
thank you, Jillian, behind the camera. So Toy Story, To Infinity and Beyond. A line angle, even though my little piece is only about an inch, it's gonna go on forever and ever. So every strip that I lay around these five line angles, that strip needs to be laid next to the center line angle. So for instance, if I was to take a ruler, line angle number one, while it's this short, it really goes on and on, all right? So we're gonna go ahead, I'm just gonna sew this piece down. And you don't really need to backstitch when you're doing crazy quilting. But you can see that I have the center line angle stitched down, right side up. Now, every other strip that I lay are going to be right sides together. And we want to work in a counterclockwise fashion. So I'm going to take my next strip, line angle one is here, and I'm going to place it right sides together. And if you can see this, I'll move it down just a little bit. I'm going to start sewing right here, and I'm going to stop right here. So hopefully you can see this on my side camera. So I'm going to start here, and I'm going to stop, and then I'm going to flip it back. This tail, you don't trim it until you sew over it. So let's go ahead and get started. So I'm going to sew this. And I'm gonna stop sewing right about here. Now I would be pressing this as I go. And so I've got a little iron that's probably off camera here. So I'll take it over here shortly. And I'm gonna iron it. And now you can see on the side camera over here that I have line angle number one. Now let's look at line angle number two. That line angle is very short. So what I would do is I would take my ruler, and you could actually draw the line angle. So let's kind of come up here. My line angle starts on the yellow piece because it's always dictated by the center. So if I am new to crazy quilting, this is what I have my students do. I go ahead and I lay a ruler up, and I'm going to sew from the top of my ruler all the way down to the very end. Then this little piece underneath becomes a seam allowance. So this is what I mean by your strip is going to get laid following the line angle of that center piece. So let's take another piece or another strip, And right here, sometimes I'd get confused when I first started learning to do crazy quilting. But I'm not confused if I remember the principle, the line angle follows that center piece. So I'm gonna lay my little strip right here. That line angle is short, but remember, infinity and beyond. It actually continues on down. And I've drawn my little line, which I doubt you can see on camera, but let me show you. I'm gonna start always sewing on that center piece. And then I'm just gonna hold my strip, whoops. Let's go up again here. And I'm gonna follow that imaginary line angle that continues on down. And when I get to the edge, right, I'll stop sewing. Now that's line angle number two. Again, you saw it was this long, but I've sewn all the way off the strip. Now principle number two, when it becomes a tail or a seam, when a tail becomes a seam allowance, that's when you can trim it. So this, I don't want to get caught underneath the strip. So now I'm able to go ahead and trim it. And obviously I would take care if I wasn't on camera to trim that better, but for right now, it's okay. So let me press this. You're gonna press this as you go. And now that long pink tail, that long pink tail, I'm not gonna trim that off because I have not sewn over it. It has not become a seam allowance. Line angle number three is dictated by that center piece. It starts here and it ends, but if we put our ruler, this one's a no-brainer. It's super easy. I'm gonna lay that next strip all the way across. So let's go ahead and we'll do this smaller piece, and I'm going to start at the center piece. I always start sewing there, and I sew to the end of the imaginary line angle. This is the easiest one. Line angle two is probably the hardest one because it's easy to miss it. Am I gonna cut the tail? If you guessed no, you were right. Let's go ahead and press this. All right, and I have three strips. 1, 2, 3, line angle number four is right here. Again, this one is a no-brainer. I'm looking at the original center, and I'm gonna lay my strip from here and let the tail hang out the other direction. And I'm gonna sew it. And what's great about crazy quilting is every time you do it, the block is a little bit different. I'm gonna stop, I'm gonna press. All right, let's hold this up so that you can see it here. Get the strips out of the way. And I have one little line angle left, the fifth line angle. Do you see it? So what we're going to do next is we're gonna lay our ruler here. Now this gets a little tricky. Here's my line angle, this little short distance, but I'm gonna lay my ruler so that it's even with that line angle, and my strip is gonna go all the way over here down, and I'm gonna stop sewing. So you can kind of see when I'm finished, let's see, I had a teal one underneath here. This is what it's gonna look like. I'm gonna sew from here, and I'm gonna stop right there. Now these two become tails, so I can trim them off after I've sewn them. All right, let's go ahead and do that. Now when you do crazy quilting, there's always some picking and grinning. There's always some backstitching that needs to be done, and that's why not backstitching, there's always some ripping of stitches. For instance, when I sew and keep going here, this is sewn down, so I'm gonna have to rip the stitches with scissors or a seam ripper, right? So I'm gonna start sewing here, and I'm gonna sew backwards. So I'm following that center little line angle, but remember, it goes beyond that little yellow piece. So all the way to the end. And now these two seam allowances I can trim. And of course I didn't bring a seam ripper for the video, so we'll just do what I probably shouldn't do, and we'll just kind of rip it with the tip of these little sharp scissors. So I want to sew that, if you will, because it's a seam allowance. So now I'm allowed to trim it. And then this goes back in my resource pile so that I can use the rest of the strip. All right, now I'm gonna press this. And let's hold this up. Now as I hold this up, I want you to look at the center. We have, the center has 5 angles. Now what do? Now I keep working in a counterclockwise direction, adding strips and going. So we'll just do a little fast forward video on this, and you'll watch me as I sew and go around. The same principles apply now that I've filled my 5 line angles. I never trim that tail until I sew over it and it becomes a seam allowance. So here I have my finished block. Remember the principles. Number one, you have the center 5 line angle block. And whatever strip that you're going to lay is going to follow the line angles of that center strip. Next thing is never trim your tails until you sew over them and they become a seam allowance. What I used to do wrong is I would trim my tails before I sewed over them, and by the time I got back around to that section, there was a little hole. I would end up with a hole in the middle of my crazy quilting because I trimmed my tails before I sewed over them, and that left a hole. So I hope this video has taught you and you'll give your hand a try at doing some crazy quilting. Please visit me at HopeYoder.com or on our Designs by Hope Yoder Facebook page or our Designs by Hope Yoder fan group page or on Instagram. I would love to see your blocks. Until next time, happy crafting.